Welcome to the College of Liberal Arts Award presentation. As Dean of the College, I would like to extend congratulations to each of our awards recipients and to their families and friends who have supported them in their educational endeavors. These outstanding students have distinguished themselves to be counted among the best and brightest in our college. Their hard work, commitment to excellence, late study nights, independent research have all paid off, and the entire college is very proud of each of you. I would also like to congratulate our distinguished faculty who have gone above and beyond in these trying times and who provide quality educational experiences and other high-impact activities for our students. I would also like to extend special thanks to all those who worked on this presentation, especially Mr. Lance Arnold, Dr. James Stewart, and Dr. Michelle Theriault. Your work is greatly appreciated. Please enjoy the presentation.
Mr. Ross Yonke will present awards for the Department of Art.
My name is Ross Yonke. I'm the interim head of the Department of Art at Nicholls State University, and I am here to announce the 2021 College of Liberal Arts Awards for students in the Department of Art. The Department of Art at Nicholls State University is accredited by the National Association of Schools of Art and Design. We offer a Bachelor of Fine Arts degree with concentrations in animation, art education, art history, digital art, print and web design, and studio art. The first award is the Lynn Paul Davis Outstanding Art Graduate Award. Lynn Paul Davis was an alumni of the Department of Art, and his family has created a scholarship in his honor, which is awarded to the best, most outstanding art student who's graduating in the 2020 and 2021 academic year. This award goes to Miss April Olivier McCartney. Miss McCartney has a 3.91 grade point average. She is a 2020 Artwork Scholarship recipient. She has worked tirelessly for the Department of Art to help us with High School Day, the Artworks fundraiser, our annual pottery sale, student exhibition, and many other things. She is an exceptional draftsperson. She's an exceptional ceramic artist, and she was selected by the faculty as the most outstanding graduate of 2020 and 2021. The next three awards were for students in our annual student exhibition. And our exhibition is a peer-reviewed exhibition, and we had three jurors. For art history, the juror was Dr. Michael Martin from the Department of English, Modern Languages, and Cultural Studies. The juror for the studio portion was Ms. Anne Boudreau, a sculptor from Lafayette, Louisiana. And the juror for the graphic design competition was Ms. Casey West, graphic designer for Rocket Science Design Firm in Baton Rouge. The first award is the Best in Show in Art History. It's an award for an art history research paper, and the award goes to Kristen Courtwright for her paper Caravaggio and Gentileschi, Revolutionary Painters of the Baroque. The next award is for Best in Show in Graphic Design, and it goes to Tessa Gautreau for her branding campaign for St. Francis de Sales' 150th anniversary. The final award is for Best in Show in Studio Art, and again, this award goes to April Olivier McCartney for her hand-bound book, Counting the Months in Quarantine. Thank you to all of our students for surviving a very tough year. And for doing such great work. We're proud of all of you, especially these four that we're honoring today.
Dr. Alan Alexander will present awards for the Department of English, Modern Languages and Cultural Studies and Interdisciplinary Studies.
I am Robert Alan Alexander, head of the Department of English, Modern Languages and Cultural Studies. It is my honor to acknowledge the recipients of the 2020-2021 awards from our department. which offers degrees in English and interdisciplinary studies in addition to 11 minors. Our first award is for Outstanding Graduate in Creative Writing. This award is presented to a student who has done superior work across all genres in creative writing. Typically, the student is pursuing a concentration in creative writing, and the recipient this year is Lexi Pellegrin. Lexi was nominated by Dr. Kathy Connor, who said of her, "Lexi's writing is so strong that she has won or placed in almost every award category for Mosaic in the past 2 years. For the 2021 issue, she serves as head editor, a position that requires much time and effort and responsibility. Lexi has proven to be one of the most capable and passionate students to ever work on the magazine. The next award is for Outstanding Graduate in Film Studies. This award is presented to a student who has done superior work in the area of film studies. Often the student is an English major with a concentration in film studies. However, this year our recipient is a film studies minor, and her name is Zoe Countsion. Dr. Todd Kennedy, who nominated Zoe for this award, has this to say about her accomplishments. "Zoe has stood out as among the two or three best film students in my decade plus at Nicholls State. Always engaged, always making connections, always providing insights, she is a pleasure to have in class. Her essays have won first prize in the Humanities Symposium of the Nicholls Scholar Expo for both 2020 and 2021. Our next award is for Outstanding Graduate in Literary Studies. This award is presented to a student who has distinguished him or herself in literature classes in pursuit of the literary studies concentration. The 2021 recipient is Caitlin Jones. Professor Elka Staley has this to say of her, "Caitlin's excellent literary criticism has garnered a great deal of attention and accolades, such as when she presented an award-winning paper, first at the 2019 Humanities Symposium for the Scholars Expo, and later at the South Atlantic Modern Language Association's 91st Annual Conference in Atlanta, Georgia. Caitlin is now in the process of choosing her graduate school from multiple offers, where she intends to specialize in 19th century British literature while also continuing as an author and freelance editor." The final award representing concentrations in the English major is Outstanding Graduate in Rhetoric and Writing. This award is presented to a student who distinguishes him or herself in the field of rhetoric and writing. The recipient of this award is Rixton Phillips. Dr. Eric Peller had this to say about Rixton's academic performance in his English 497 History of Rhetoric Classical to Present class. "Rixton showed remarkable enthusiasm and sophistication of thought in discussions of more than 2,000 years of rhetorical theory. His contribution to a collaborative open textbook on the history of rhetoric and entry on poetics far exceeded expectations and showcased the considerable breadth and depth of his intellectual and creative resources." Though we don't offer degree programs in French and Spanish, we like to recognize academic achievement in these areas, especially since promoting modern languages is part of our mission and part of our name. Our next award is Academic Excellence in French. This award goes to a student who shows a sincere commitment to learning French. This year's recipient is Sarah Guillot. French professor Chris Manier says the following about Sarah's achievement. "Sarah has been a model student studying literature and language with both creativity and drive. It has been a joy to watch her thrive in French, a language she first encountered growing up in Pierre Part, and one that seems destined to play some important role in her future, as her recent efforts suggest. Sarah represents this university beautifully, just as she is a tremendous ambassador for French, for the complex culture of the Bayou region, and for the love of learning itself." The next award is for Academic Excellence in Spanish. This award is presented to a student who displays dedication to learning Spanish. The recipient of the Spanish award is Taylor Hodson. According to Spanish professor Bryant Smith, "Taylor is a hardworking and dedicated student who always goes the extra mile to complete quality work. She works well independently, but is also willing to help her classmates to understand difficult concepts. For these reasons, Taylor is a deserving recipient of this award." Our final award is for Outstanding Graduate in Interdisciplinary Studies. This award is presented to a student who exhibits academic excellence in coursework and whose course of study illustrates a diverse range of interests and specialties, as reflected in the attainment of multiple academic minors. The recipient of this award is Zoe Concion. Zoe's outstanding work while pursuing a Bachelor of Arts in Interdisciplinary Studies and minors in Film Studies, Histories, and Humanities has impressed both faculty and staff. Professor Tiffany Dewey, Zoe's senior seminar instructor, says that Zoe produces terrific work through her fine attention to detail. In her career portfolio, she successfully showcases various skill sets and her wide-ranging studies in liberal arts, making her a soon-to-be outstanding alumna. All of the preceding recipients will receive a $100 check as part of their award. On behalf of the faculty and staff of our department, I again congratulate you for your remarkable achievements.
Dr. Paul Wilson will present awards for the Department of History and Geography.
Hello, I'm Dr. Paul Wilson, Department Head of History and Geography, and I'm here to present awards to five outstanding history majors. Our first award is the Philip D. Yuse Award for Academic Excellence in History. It's awarded to the top student or students in history as evidenced by GPA, GPA in history, and research ability. It is named for a former history professor at Nichols, and it's open to seniors and recent graduates. This year, we have three recipients of this award, although all five students receiving awards are deserving of this honor. Our first recipient is Ryan Lyons. Ryan is a member of multiple honor societies on campus. She has published in Mosaic, and she is the current president of the History Honor Society, Phi Alpha Theta. She completed a service learning project at the Chauvin Sculpture Garden and an internship in the Nichols Archives. Ryan plans to attend graduate school next year to pursue a master's degree in library and information science to become a librarian or archivist. Our next award winner is Samantha Schecksnyder. Samantha is also a member of several honor societies on campus. She is completing a bachelor's degree in history with minors in political science and international studies. She is also completing an honors thesis on World War II in the Pacific, using oral histories of U.S. Marines and various secondary sources examining the experiences of these brave men in five key battles. She intends to enroll in graduate school this fall to pursue a master's degree in history. Our third recipient of the Philip D. Yuse Award for Academic Excellence in History is Drew Terrio. Drew is also a member of several honors societies at Nichols. He is a member of the Nichols Honors Program and is completing an honors thesis on the history of education in Louisiana. He will graduate in May in history with minor fields in sociology and political science. He intends to enroll in graduate school to pursue a master's degree in history. Our next award is the History Education Award that goes to the student majoring in history and social studies education with the highest grade point average. This year's recipient is Kelsey Groh. Kelsey graduated in December 2020 with two bachelor's degrees, one in history and one in social studies education. She was a member of Delta Zeta sorority, served as president of SEALS, worked as a peer tutor for academic services, was copy editor of the Nicholsworth, and a member of the 2019 Nichols Homecoming Court. She also served as the 2020 president of Phi Alpha Theta History Honor Society. She is currently teaching social studies at Labneyville Middle School. Our last award is given to the history major in our Nichols online program with the highest grade point average. This year's recipient is Christopher Clough. Christopher is originally from Dearborn, Michigan. He has a bachelor's degree from Bowling Green State in sport management, and he received his bachelor's degree in history from Nichols this past December. He is enrolled in graduate school at Pittsburgh State University in the master's degree program in history. He is currently the director of Parks, Recreation, Facilities, and Safety for the city of Lathrop Village, Michigan, but hopes to one day become a history professor, a professional genealogist, and a writer. He and his husband, Doug, are raising four kids, two cats, and a dog. Congratulations to all of our recipients who endured a very difficult year at Nichols, but maintain absolutely excellent academic standards.
Dr. James Stewart will present awards for the Department of Mass Communications.
To say that students at Nichols faced unique hurdles over the last year is a gross understatement. But the students in the Mass Communication Department faced increased challenges during the pandemic shutdown. They, like other students, had to figure out ways to make the switch from a lecture course to hybrid. They had to figure out ways to replace the lost income from that job that was closed down during the lockdown. But they also had to figure out ways to continue to tell those special stories that make their time here at Nichols unique. So it gives me special pleasure to present this year's list of award winners. The first award is the Clarence Ducé Reporting Award. This award was created by John Grabois, who had covered the White House and the first Gulf War. He established this award for a student who did a series of articles, including feature stories and news stories. The award comes with a $200 prize, and this year's winner is Brandon Thomas. The next award is also a writing award, the Bonnie Toops Wells Award. This award was established by Ken Wells, a former Wall Street Journal front page editor and a finalist for the Pulitzer Prize. This is for feature writing. The award is named for Ken Wells' mother. This year's winner is Shakira Butler, who receives a $250 check. The third award is for our outstanding journalism graduate. The Mass Communication Department has two concentrations, journalism and public relations, and this year's winner for the journalism track is Addie Wetzel. The next award is for the outstanding public relations graduate. Public relations is an area where we teach students to help organizations, including nonprofits, get their stories out to the public. This year's winner is Peyton Swear. The next award is for the Nichols Players. The Nichols Players is the group that puts on theatrical productions, and although we do not have a major in theater, we do have a very active theater program. This award is named in honor of Mel Berry, a longtime Nichols Players director. This year's winner, Lauren Monso, has been very active in productions, serving both as an actor and director and producer of theatrical productions. The final award is named for Alfred Delahaye. Alfred Delahaye is the man who created the Mass Communication Department, and so we name the outstanding overall graduate from the department in his honor. This year, and it's happened a couple times in the past, we have two co-winners. The first is Jade Hawkins. You can see she's a two-time president of PRSSA and served as a Mass Communication Department intern. The second winner is Peyton Swear. She is a member of the Kappa Tau Alpha Honor Society, which is a very prestigious honor. Very few programs in the nation have a chapter, and we're fortunate to have one here. She's also a holder of the Walsh Scholarship and the director of PR campaigns for St. Genevieve Catholic School. I would like to thank all of you for your attendance today and to give special recognition and thanks for those students who did such an excellent job to win these awards.
Dr. Michael Bartnick will present awards for the Department of Music.
Hi, I'm Michael Bartnick with the Department of Music. Our students have shown so much resiliency within the past year, struggling through the challenges of the pandemic. They've all worked hard to continue to collaborate and perform every opportunity that they were presented with. This year, the Department of Music presents six awards to music students that rose above the challenges and continued to perform and offer their service to the department. All four of the Outstanding Major Award winners were selected from outstanding juries, recital hour performances, and junior and senior recitals. The Outstanding Piano Major is Scarlett Ellender from the studio of Dr. Luciana Suarez. She was presented the award in the Undergraduate Performing Arts Competition for Scholars Expo, selected to perform at the Academic Summit Performing Arts Showcase in 2020 and 2021, and plans to pursue her master's in music at LSU in the fall. The outstanding instrumental major is Erica Benoit from the studio of Dr. Jason Ladd. She has been Pride of Nichols band captain, won the Medal of Honor Pride of Nichols State Marching Award, has been a participant in the CBDNA Honor Band as well as the Intercollegiate Marching Band. She is currently student teaching. The outstanding string major is Ramses Dominguez from the studio of James Alexander. He came to study at Nichols from the Dominican Republic and has studied with Paul Cantor, Timothy Cantor, and James Alexander. The outstanding vocal major is Darius Scott from the studio of Dr. Valerie Francis. He has been a first place, third place winner at the regional and state level of NATS. He is also a previous winner of the College of Liberal Arts Awards for the Outstanding Service and Outstanding Vocal Major. The next two winners have been extremely dedicated to the department as well as advocates for each of their main performing ensembles. Precious Yanez has been a drum major for the Pride of Nichols. She serves as vice president of membership for Sigma Alpha Iota and has directed the clarinet choir at H.L. Bourgeois. Erin Tomplay is the recipient of the American Choral Directors Association Award. She currently is serving her second year as choir president. She is a music education vocal major, and she has run independent rehearsals for the choirs. I would like to congratulate all of the award winners from the Department of Music.
Dr. David Whitney will present awards for the Department of Social Sciences.
Hi, I'm David Whitney. I'm the department head of Social Sciences. We have three degree programs: political science, criminal justice, and sociology. Our motto is cultivating civic virtue, and I think that's even more important today in light of what we've just been through over this past year. With the pandemic. These students that I'm going to announce today have all done an outstanding job sort of navigating this pandemic. And I think it's even more important than ever that we're sending students out into the real world that think not only of their own self-interest, but also of improving the community. And certainly all of these students, as you'll see when I go through the individuals, have a goal to do work that is ultimately socially impactful. So I'll start with the Political Science Award. So the first award goes to Carly Watts. This is the Political Science Academic Excellence Award. We actually have two winners this year because Ms. Watts, along with the other winner, both have a 4.0 GPA. So it's kind of hard to beat that. Carly is actually working right now on an honors thesis with me, and she also plans to go to graduate school to study political science and possibly to get a PhD, but certainly to get a master's, and she might have interest in going to actually teach at a university after. Our next award winner, also of the Academic Excellence Award, is Lane Robichaux. He also has a perfect 4.0 GPA, and Lane is pursuing the path that's actually most common for our political science majors, which is he's preparing to go to law school and hopes to open his own law practice one day. Our final award winner for political science is actually, this is our inaugural award for the online program. So we started Nichols Online Program in Political Science 3 years ago. Ms. Erin Romero is our first graduate, or among our first graduates of that program, and she has the best GPA among Nichols Online program, and she plans to go to graduate school for public administration, to get a master's of public administration. Our next awards are in criminal justice. So the first is the Academic Excellence Award. This is the top GPA among criminal justice students, and it goes to Maria Smith. And Maria Smith is planning on going to graduate school as well to get her master's in forensic psychology. And she has the ultimate goal of becoming an agent of the FBI. The next award winner is Mr. Jonathan Dean. He's getting the Outstanding Graduating Senior Award. This is one that looks at not just academic achievement, but commitment to the program as a whole, and it's eligible for seniors of criminal justice. Jonathan has a real passion for criminal justice and has had it since well before attending Nichols, and he plans to go work for the Louisiana State Police with the hopes of ultimately becoming a U.S. Marshal. And then finally, when we get to the sociology program, we have three awards there. The Academic Excellence Award in Sociology goes to the top GPA among traditional sociology students, and this year's award winner is Ms. Emily Evans. Ms. Evans plans to attend LSU to pursue her master's of social work and ultimately wants to open her own counseling practice. The next award winner is Ms. Chrissy Terrio. She has also Academic Excellence in Sociology Award. She has the top GPA among Nichols Online students. She's looking also to pursue a master's degree in social work. And finally, the Sociology Spirit Award goes to Ms. Arielle Nunnery. This is given to the sociology student that's really sort of most involved and shows, kind of embodies the spirit of sociology. Ms. Nunnery was in all sorts of organizations, so the Women's Leadership Association, the Black Student Union, NAACP, the Social Club, Sociology Club, just to name a few. So she has won the Sociology Spirit Award. I want to thank you for joining us. I wish we could have done this in person. We're very, very proud of all of these students, really of all our students in general, for overcoming this last challenging year. And we're very confident that the students that have won these awards are really going to represent not just our department, but the entire university out in the community. And they're really going to make an impact, not just for themselves, but for the community at large.
As we close the 2021 College of Liberal Arts Award Ceremony, I would like to thank everyone who had a part in creating this event. All liberal arts department heads, Ms. Jean Donegan, interim dean, And a special thanks to Mr. Lance Arnold, who did all the filming and editing while he was balancing all other semester duties. I would also like to offer a final congratulations to all of our night's awardees. Thank you for sharing your time and talent and creativity with all of us. Your spirit creates a dynamic classroom environment, not only for your fellow students, but for your professors as well. You give us more than you realize. It's exciting to imagine what you'll do next. Thank you.